Hi, I am Purani and I read the Summer Adventure Stories by Enid Blyton last week. Enid Blyton is the most popular children authors of all time. She has written more than 600 books which has been translated into many languages. Enid Blyton adored writing for children. Millions of children and grown-ups around the world have read her stories. This book of summer adventure stories contains 25 stories. All the stories in this series are nice and were written originally in each of her books. My favorite picks are In the Heart of the Wood, The Very Brave Puppy, Sailor Jim's Telescope, The Girl Who Was Left Behind, Adventure for Two, The Train That Broke in Half, Granny's Lovely Necklace, and Kawadi Custard. I'm going to tell about these stories. The first story is In the Heart of the Wood. Billy and Sally with their dogs Camp go to the heart of the wood. They find a hollow tree and they climb into it, and they find it's a place for hiding the stolen goods. At midnight, the robbers come and take their rope away which they used to climb in the hollow. They were inside the tree, but the dog's camp was outside the tree. Now the dog's camp rescues them. Don't wonder how a dog can rescue them, because camp did. To find out how he did, please read this book. The next story is The Very Brave Puppy. One day when returning from school, Martin and Claire find a little puppy struggling to swim in a pond. They pick it and take it to their home, but their mother wouldn't let them keep it. While going to get a haircut, they wanted to leave it in the dog's home so that it could be taken care of. The children and their father drove in a car and went to the hairdresser's shop. During the haircut, the robbers come and try to steal their car, but the puppy stops them. Next, what happens? You want to know? Please do read the book. Now I'm going to proceed to Sailor Jim's telescope. Sailor Jim had a telescope. He used to give it to the children to have a look for 10 pence. One day George came and said that he had won a scholarship and he wanted the telescope. He was worried about giving it, but later his own telescope saved the life of his mother. Very strange, isn't it? If you want to know more, read the book. I will proceed to the next story. It is The Girl Who Was Left Behind. All the children in Mrs. Williams' class were going to have a day by the sea. They were all excited. Miss Williams told them to be punctual, as the coach they were going to the sea would arrive at 10 o'clock and would wait for them only for 10 minutes. All of them went back home excitedly. The next day, Alice and her friend Minnie were going to the school to reach the coach. On the way, a boy fell down, hurt himself. Alice wanted to help him, but Minnie was selfish and said that she would miss the coach and ran away without Alice. But alas, Alice misses the coach when she tried to help him. She was very sad and thought, "I just stopped to be kind." On the way back home, she meets the boy. His name is Donald and he tries to comfort her. Now Donald repays the kindness that she had done. Now Alice has a day by the sea after all. You want to know how? You know what to do. Of course, go through the story. As you know, the next adventurous story is Adventure for Two. Philip and Mary's dad was a doctor who went to see ill people every day. One day, Mrs. Beckley has sprained her ankle and their father went to see her. Mrs. Beckley had a nice yellow hedge with the children often loved to play in. When their dad went to see her and went into the cottage, he told his children that they should take care of the car so that robbers do not steal his precious case of medicines. But they do not obey their dad. Now the precious case is stolen. Will they ever be able to find it? You could read it so that you may know. So the next story is The Train That Broke in Half. Benny was a little boy who was always shy of everything. He was a very timid little boy. His father always told him to join the running races, but he always said, "I would lose the race, so I'd better stay at home." But one day, Benny does something special. Has he become a hero? Just read to know. So what are we waiting for? Come on, let's proceed to the next story, that is Granny's lovely necklace. Granny had a very precious necklace that she always liked. But one day while going boating with her grandchildren Jim and Eileen, she loses it. But Jim and Eileen cancels their picnic and goes to find Granny's necklace. They decided to catch shrimps, but instead they caught the lovely necklace. How do you think they caught it? So just read it. The last story in my favorite picks is Kavadi Custard. Charlie was a boy who would not play rough games with the other children. He was, of course, not like Benny, which we just read in The Train That Broke in Half. Only the thing that his parents were poor and couldn't afford to give him healthy meals. But one day he saves the valuable fox terrier dog of Mrs. Williams and his headmaster gives him a reward of lots of money. With this, his parents can give him healthy meals and now he's a very strong boy and he could beat everybody in all those rough games. But how did he ever save that valuable fox terrier? All you know to read. So you just have to read. So this brings it to the end. And this is the my favorite stories in this book. I just shared them so that you may also find it interesting. See you later. Bye bye.